Hi guys, this is going to be a video about why video game sports is so popular. Why do we like playing games that contain simulations of real sporting athletes, real sporting situations? What is it about these games that make us want to continue to play? I can tell you one thing that doesn't make me want to continue to play them is that I'm going to be able to accumulate a certain amount of cards and then therefore pump up my player ratings and my player ratings. That's not getting it for me. I'm like Herm Edwards. You play to win the games. That's why we play. But not only that reason. And I'm just going to be scrolling as I talk to you. No particular reason why I'm scrolling. I'm just scrolling. I guess it's partially to show you the different amount of years and time that I've put into these video games. I'm on PlayStation 3, even though my nickname is PS2. I do have a PlayStation 3 channel, too. I have PS3 Sports Info Station out there, guys. I haven't put up anything in a while. I'm going to start putting up some stuff because PS3 was a formidable opponent to PS2, whereas now not so much PS4, in my opinion. But anyway, we play these games for this reason. It's the bottom of the ninth. Your team is losing 3-2. The bases are loaded. The count on you is 3-2. The pitcher's been getting you on this curveball that's got a vicious tail on it that hooks and it's got you swinging looking silly most of the game. But now it's put up or shut up time. You need at least a base hit. A fly ball won't get it because that'll be the third out. So the runner's going to stay at third. A walk is okay because if you walk, at least the game is tied and you send it to extra innings. So it's up to you to stay alive in the box. What will you do? That's why we play. Because you believe, and I believe, that I'm going to get a base hit, or hit a grand slam, or walk. And it feels real. And if you don't do it, to show you how real it feels, that's when you might toss your controller over to the next part of the room. Or let out a big you-know-what and your parent or your spouse come in and say, what's going on? Because you use the expletive delete. Because it didn't go down the way it should. But if you get the base hit, if you hit the grand slam, oh, they come in anyway saying, what's wrong with you? What are you doing all that yelling for? Because it felt real. That's why. Or you're in the NBA 2K19. The opposing team hits a shot with 5 seconds left on the clock, which puts them up 99-98. You call a timeout. You have to inbounds the ball at the half court line. Do you try and alley-oop it to your big for a dunk? Or do you kick it to one of your wing players to shoot a three? Either way, you win the game. If he dunks it, you win by two. You win by one. If you hit the three, you win by two. If you miss it, you go home looking like Deputy Dog. This is why we play these games. for these situations to occur. And then, let's say you hit that shot, okay? Or you're playing a game and you just, it's a team you can't stand. If you're a Cub fan, that's the Cardinals. If you're a Cardinal fan, that's the Cubs. If you're a Bulls fan, that's the Pistons. If you're a Pistons fan, that's the Celtics. You know what I'm saying. And it's that team. And you beat that team that your real team can't never beat. And they always wear you out like the Twins wear out the Chicago White Sox. They're always a thorn in the side of the White Sox. Every team's got a team that's a thorn that just gets on your nerves that you watch so that you can see your team beat them. It might be the Mets playing the Yankees or vice versa, the Yankees playing the Mets. It might be Boston and the Yankees. And you're playing in that rivalry and that situation, baseball situation occurs that I just told you about where it's 3-2, you're losing 3-2, bottom of the ninth, two outs, bases loaded, counts 3-2, and you're either the Red Sox or the Yankees. You just feel it. And if you are successful, it feels great. If you're not, you feel like a goofball. Okay? So that's why I love to play video game sports. Because with me being handicapped now, I lost my leg back in 2016, my right leg, to diabetes. It just really brings me back to my days, my summer days when I was in high school, and all I did was play baseball, 7 days a week, baseball. Couldn't wait to get to the field, baseball. Loved it that much. So, when I play baseball especially, I seem to be dominant in MLB, in triple play, in MVP, whatever, because I have a real true passion for baseball. I love it. Okay? So that's why we play the games. And I'm guessing that that's why you play it too. You know, it doesn't matter if you weren't the star. If you were a star athlete or you were the last guy to come off the bench, you know the feeling that if you hit that shot with 5 seconds left, and let's even soup it up more, it's game 7 of the NBA Finals with 5 seconds. You hit the shot, you win the series. Your hometown fans go crazy. The cheerleaders will be giving you their telephone numbers, and you will have a full little black book. And you know this. But if you don't hit the shot, you won't get no numbers. You'll go back to your hotel room by yourself and think about it. That's what makes sports great. You get opportunity to be a hero. And in these video games, you can relive that. There is no doubt about it. No better feeling than if you're making a YouTube video. And that situation that I told you about, and it has come up with me. It has happened. Where I've been losing the whole game. And if I just come up with the big hit, I can win the game in the ninth, even though the other team was beating my butt the whole game. Ain't nothing. It's just an outstanding feeling in sports when you never give up and you win. Perfect example of that is Fight Night Champions. When you're fighting as Andre Bishop and you finally defeat Isaac Frost, it will never be a better feeling you'll have playing a sports video game than that. Take it from me. And for those of you who think it's impossible to beat Isaac Frost, I gave you the video game evidence on YouTube. You can do it. Well, here's what you don't know about the original film that I made about Andre Bishop winning the heavyweight championship and me defeating Isaac Frost. At the time that I did that, I was sick. Things were happening with my body that I did not understand. Diabetes was ravaging through my limbs, taking a toll on my total health. But I played that game constantly, trying to figure out how can I beat this dude? And he talks so much stuff, it just makes it even worse. It is a great game. Once you win, it's no better feeling. It's like real sports, okay? So that's why we play the games, for the homers, for the last second shot, for the last second touchdown pass, or the last second running it in for two to win the game by one, either in college football or pro football. That's what makes it great. And even if you slaughter your arch rival in any sport, whether it be Boston, if you slaughter, the Lakers, or the Lakers, if you slaughter the Celtics, it's a feeling of of real sports accomplishment in video game sports. The great games, not just any old, game they throw out there, but your NBA Lives, your NBA 2Ks, your Madden NFL football, your MLB The Show, your MVP, all of those great games give you those moments as a sports fan. So that's my take on why we play video games and why they are so popular, especially the sports video games. That's it. Have a great day. Thanks for watching and listening. I appreciate it. Bye.